In this video, we're going to look at fixing the WordPress not sending emails issue by connecting WordPress to Office 365 or Outlook and using that as our SMTP service. Hey, I'm Ryan from WP Beginner. If you have a form on your site like a contact form, then your website will be responsible for sending emails out every time that form is completed. If your website isn't sending emails out, then that can be down to your hosting provider not having the PHP mail function turned on. The best solution for this, and one that we actually recommend even if you don't currently have this issue, is to use the Simple Mail Transfer Protocol, or SMTP, as it's the industry standard for sending emails. Now, this may all sound very technical and beyond the scope of most WordPress website owners, but it really is not, and that's because in this video, we're going to break it down and go step by step. First, we're going to install the WP Mail SMTP plugin on our WordPress site, and then choose Office 365 or Outlook as our mailer option and follow the process from there. To install the WP Mail SMTP plugin, log into your WordPress dashboard and then head to Plugins here on the left. Hover over that and then click on Add New. Now we're going to head over to the search bar over here and put in WP Mail SMTP. Now the search results have come up. This is the plugin we want right here. I'm just going to click on the Install Now button. And once that's installed, this button will turn into an Activate button and you can click on that. Now that the plugin's activated, it's brought you to this setup wizard here. And we're going to go through this step by step. So click the Let's Get Started button. I'm going to choose 365 Outlook. Now, as we're using WP Mail SMTP Lite, it's giving us an option now to upgrade to the Pro if we want to use Office 365 or Outlook. So we're going to do that. So now it's brought you to the WP Mail SMTP website and you can go through and upgrade to the Pro version. Once you've upgraded, log into your account. Now you've logged into your WP Mail SMTP account, you want to find your license key information, and that is right here. So you click on this link here and then copy your license key. Now you want to go back to your WordPress dashboard. And now we're back on this screen, click off the pop-up, scroll to the bottom, close and exit the setup wizard. That'll bring you back to the plugin settings screen. And as you can see right here, you can paste your license key. Click the orange button to connect. Now you're going to go through the setup wizard to connect and install the Pro version of the WP Mail SMTP. And once that's done, you click the blue OK button. That's brought you back to the settings screen of the plugin. You can now go into the setup wizard, click the Let's Get Started. And now we can select Microsoft 365 or Outlook. Scroll down and click Save and Continue. Again, we get another pop-up just telling us that this might be a little bit more technical than other options. So if you prefer a more straightforward setup, then we recommend using something like SendLayer. But I'm going to continue with this process. There are a few things that we need to set up for us to be able to connect Office 365 to WP Mail SMTP. We've got a link here to the written setup process that I'm going to go through right now. And the information we need to configure this mailer up is the application ID and application password, which we're going to create. So what we need to do that is head over to Microsoft Azure and set everything up there. The link to that will be in the description below. Now we're on the Microsoft Azure website, we can sign in with our Office 365 or Outlook email address. And now we've logged into Microsoft Azure, we're going to come up here to the search bar, type in app, and what we're looking for is app registrations, so click on that. So as you can see, we've got no registrations currently, we're going to add a new registration. Now on this screen, we just need to give this app a name, so I'm just going to name it WP Mail SMTP. And the supported account types, we're going to select the accounts in any organization directory right here. And here we can see right here, we've got the redirect URI. And we're going to select the platform for that, so it's a web platform. And then head back over to the setup wizard, copy the redirect URI right here. Head back over to Azure and paste in what we've just copied from the setup wizard. We can now click on the blue register button down here. So once that's done, we can now see that we've got our application or client ID. We're going to copy that and head over back over to the setup wizard and paste that in here. Now we just need an application password. So we're going to go back to Azure. And to do that, we're going to click on certificates and secrets. And once we're on this page, we're going to click on add new client secret. So now we've got this pop-up on the right-hand side. In the description, I'm just going to put app_password. We can keep the recommended 6 months expiry. Click the blue add button. And now what we need to do is just copy the value right here. Head back over to our setup wizard and paste it in there. Scroll down and connect to Microsoft. We just have to enter our sign-in details to authorize this and then just give relevant permissions for Microsoft. And now we get the success message. click on OK. Now we're going to scroll to the bottom, and our from email needs to be the same as our authorized email up here. Let's copy that. Click save and continue. Now this page is just showing you the features that are enabled in WP Mail SMTP plugin. Click save and continue. And now that's all set up, we see this page and we can finish the setup process. And now we have WP Mail SMTP connected to the Microsoft SMTP service. I really hope this video helped you fix the WordPress not sending emails issue. If you like this video and are interested in getting more features from an SMTP service, then check this video out, where we show you how to connect SendLayer to your WordPress site. Thanks for watching.